गुड मॉर्निंग एंड जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम कंचन एंड दिस टाइम आई हैव टेकन द चैप्टर बर्थ. सो हियर दिस इज चैप्टर बर्थ बाय एजे क्रॉनी हु वाज अ स्कॉटिश एंड ही वाज बोर्न ऑन जुलाई 1896 एंड ही डाइड ऑन जनवरी 6, 1981. नाउ theme of this chapter is to keep going to accomplish every deed no matter what adversities we have to face, what adversities come in front of us, and we have to just do the need whatever we have to do. So here in this chapter also the doctor here, I am telling you about the characters. So here Dr. Andrew Manson and Joe Morgan. So characters are four here. First Dr. Andrew Manson, and then second is Joe Morgan and his wife, and then his wife's mother. So four characters are. One more is there also, a nurse is there. So here Dr. Morgan, I would like to tell you, Dr. Morgan had completed his medical education and he was doing his practice under Dr. Edward Page in a small mining town named Blenley. So he was keeping practice, and in this chapter we will read how he had continued his efforts and he had made the dead child alive, right? So here he was there. It was late night, and then Dr. Morgan was there. Dr. Andrew was there coming to his house, and then there Joe Morgan was waiting for him. And at that time doctor was thinking about his girlfriend. Some dispute were there, and then he was thinking about that thing, and then he saw Joe Morgan. He was waiting because Joe Morgan's wife was pregnant, and as she was about to give a baby, means birth to a baby. So it was the time there, and he was waiting for the doctor, and then when doctor reached there, when doctor was there, then he was relaxed and he said that doctor, my wife was expecting to deliver a baby after 20 years of our marriage. He told that my wife is about to give birth to a baby after 20 years of our marriage. Then Joe Morgan stopped outside the house. Then what happened? Dr. Andrew was ready to move with Joe Morgan, and he went there. But Joe Morgan didn't enter into his house. He stopped outside. He was terrified badly, and he was thinking that doctor will do. What can I do this time? For that reason. Then Susan was his wife. She was lying there in a small room, and then they went upstairs, and there she was lying. She was lying down there in a room. The doctor reached a small, clean but scantily furnished room, and he found two women were there. Susan Morgan's mother and Susan herself was there. Susan's mother offered him a cup of tea, and then doctor told that mother, don't worry, I will stay here, and I will complete my job, whatever is to be done. Then an hour later Dr. Andrew went to check the patient, because he was going to check his patient what was the condition at that time, whether the baby was about to take birth or it has some time left. So he was thinking that the restless footsteps of Joe Morgan, because Joe Morgan was worried about that. In fact, all of them, they were worried because the baby was about to take birth after 20 years. So all of them were worried about that. And Dr. Andrew had convinced them made assured that everything will be fine, and he said that I will be here. Dr. Andrew was so deep in his thought, he was thinking, because there was time in birth of the baby, so he was thinking about many people who have who were there hopeless with their marriage. Many things he was thinking, and he was deeply thinking. He was totally involved in his thoughts. Then Dr. Andrew was so deep in his thought that the voice of the old lady, Susan Morgan's mother, she was an old lady, she told that there is pain and maybe this is the accurate time of delivery. Then Dr. Andrew replied that it would do no harm, and then Sushant's mother told that chloroform will be harmful for the baby, as Sushant was saying. Then doctor said no, it will have no bad effect, no side effect will be there. After a harsh struggle for an hour, the child was born, but it was totally dead child, and the body of the child was totally white, and it was not pink colored, and it was lifeless. Its neck was there rolling down one side, and it was totally loose body. So doctor was also shocked and thinking that I have assured that everything will be fine. Then he was there thinking what could he do. At the sudden moment, the mother's condition was also becoming down, and he had to attend mother also. So then she was becoming unconscious at that time after delivery. Then doctor went there and he injected her. After that, his condition was stable, but the main condition of the child was there to take care. Then he just thought about one incident when a dead baby was born, and then it was dipped in a hot water, then in a cold water, then hot water, then cold water. He suddenly remembered. Then he ordered the nurse to bring hot water and then cold water. He took out the dead body, which was kept beneath the bed. It was kept because the nurse was there thinking that the baby was absolutely died and nothing can be done. So what did he do? She just put the dead body under the bed, and she had thought it is thoughtless to think about that. Then she brought hot water and cold water. Then Dr. Andrew took out the dead body of the child, and it was almost loose body. Then he dipped the body into hot water. It was bearable water. It was warm water. It was bearable also. That temperature was according to that. He dipped once in hot water, then in cold water, then hot water, then cold water. He did it 15 times, and he was there sweating due to doing hard work, but he continued. After that, nothing was there in baby's body. Nothing was there, no commotion, no beating, no heart beating. Then he was at that time thinking what can be done right now. He was thinking about that. Then he just took his chest, and he pressed his chest also, and pushing his thrust with his palm. Again he was thinking, and he was totally sweating at that time. But suddenly he had felt beating. Oh, what! He was surprised. He was very happy. The baby was there, and the beating was there, reviving there, and he was getting back his life. And then his nerves started, and he cried. Then he became very happy. Thank God. Oh God. Oh God. Thank God. Oh God, he has come alive. Doctor was very happy at that time, relaxed also, because he did his best, and he was thinking. Then he came out and said there to Joe Morgan that everything is fine, and he thanked God, "Oh God, everything is fine," and then his efforts came true. So this is about this story that we have come to know that keeping efforts is very good. We have to do our efforts, and continuously we have to do. Thank you and Jai.